Right, so good afternoon and thank you for giving us this opportunity to present a case in your wonderful conference. We are really excited to be here with you. And let me first introduce our Heart Foundation to you. So National Heart Foundation Hospital and Research Institute, where we work, is a non-government, non-profit organization. It is a 565-bedded tertiary cardiac care hospital in Dhaka, Bangladesh, and we try to provide modern cardiac treatment to our patients at a very affordable cost. We started with a single cath lab in 1999. At present, we have 7 cath labs, and in 2023, we did more than 25,000 cases, and we started doing left main PCR on a regular basis since 2007, and by this last year we did a total of more than 4,693 left main cases. We also do rotavation on a regular basis since 2015, and we've done up till now a total of 375 rotavation cases. So without further ado, let me introduce our case to you. So this is a 75-year-old male. He has a very long history of chronic coronary syndrome. His angina was getting progressively worse even with maximal anti-anginal therapy. And he had severe multiple vessel disease. Yesterday, 5 days ago actually, we did his PCI to his RCA. He's a diabetic, with CKD, creatinine being 2.8%, his ejection fraction is 46%, and this is his angiogram. Now you can appreciate that he has severe distal left main disease, around 80%. The LAD is also heavily calcified, having 90 to 95% long segment stenosis, starting from the origin. Diagonal is a large size vessel having 80 to 90% stenosis at its origin. LCS is also heavily calcified and totally occluded from its origin, and it is filled by collapses from the right coronary artery. Now the right coronary artery, this is how the right coronary artery looks. It has a 90 to 95% lesion, moderate calcification in its proximal segment starting from the ostium, a bit of an anomalous origin of the ostium. So what we did is, we decided to tackle the right side 5 days ago. So the right side, as we had no support from the left side, we did not go for rotavation in this side, and also our balloons passed, which was also an indication that we could get away with balloon angioplasty. So we did predilatation, a very thorough job of predilatation with NC scoring balloons and cutting balloon for the ostia. After proper predilatation, we used drug-eluting stents starting from the ostia. We did post-dilatation, and this was the final result 5 days ago. Now coming to today, let us go to the case today. Can you show the case to us, please? This is the left side. Can you see the left side, please, today? So this is RC. We just took a shot prior to doing the case. So you can see the right side looks just fine. And then this is the left side. You can see the heavy calcification visible in the angiography. And this is how it looks with our dye. Very severe distal left main disease, diffuse LAD, calcified, LCX-CTO, heavily calcified. Diagonal also diseased. So we wired the vessel with the help of a fine cross microcatheter and a run-through wire, and we attempted to pass a 1.25 balloon, and as you can see, the balloon did not pass. So this was a clear indication, and we were pretty sure from the start also that we would be needing a rotavation here. But just to show that this was indeed very heavily calcified, 1.25 balloon also refused to go. So without further ado, we changed to a rota wire, and we did rota ablation with a 1.5 millimeter burn. This is just what we did, and we did quite a few runs. there was quite a huge chunk of calcium in the mid part of the LAV, which we struggled a bit with. But after three runs, we gave a polished run, and so that's us with a 1.5 bird. So after we did the rotor ablation, we changed our rotor wire for our workhorse wire, which is the run-through floppy wire. And after this, as you can see, we wanted to do IVUS, but our IVUS machine didn't work, so we had to take our OCT. And as you can see, the OCT went very easily, and we just took a shot. So this is when you came to joined us. So we've just taken the shot with the OCT, and we can go to the. We've also not seen what the OCT showed us, but we can have a look together right now. So this is the OCT run. Can you hear us?
Yes.
Ajal is well audible and well seen.
Yeah, great. So as you can see, it's a very long, diffuse, calcified lesion, which we have managed to rotor ablate. The patient has tolerated the rotor ablation quite well. And you can see we are going to the tightest part.
I think at the 12 o'clock, there is a nice rotor effect. You see the very nice round shape, that's a rotor effect. And around the rotor, we see the platelet-rich thrombus as well. So this is a distal segment. This is okay, no rotor effect. Coming back, that's some thrombus. More, this is like 180 degree of the calcium in the 12 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 6 o'clock. That's some thrombus, but that's okay. Come back proximally, and that's like the 6 o'clock, nice rotor effect, it's Polish, and then go more, and calcium fracture, you're right, 6 o'clock, and then more. This is nice rotor effect, you see the nice Polish surface? Yeah, that's nice Polish surface, and calcium fracture on the top. And this is probably calcified nodule in the 6 o'clock we just passed, yeah. Then the proximal portion. So it looks like, here is the best picture. It's 12 o'clock, you see the nice round shape that's really made by the rotor ablator. So quite significant calcium and calcified nodule and some fracture and good rotor effect.
How will it recognize the difference with the calcified nodule versus nodular calcium? Yeah. Could you please explain?
So this case, I do think, yeah, this is not the nodular. Come back to the some. Yeah, here. Yeah, okay. Yeah, that's perfect. I think this is eruptive type of the nodular, eruptive type of the calcified nodule. So typically they can fracture or redistribute without too much. But I think underlying calcium is a lot. So not only the eruptive calcified nodule, but also the underlying calcium has to be treated together. And then that's how rotor worked. Yeah.
So you will agree that in this kind of heavily calcified vessel, the only tool that would really work was a rotor. And it's done a brilliant job, I think, because we could even take our wire. Now we plan to do a more preparation of our lesion, and we are planning to do it with scoring balloons, NC scoring balloon. And so we are taking a 3x10 NC scoring balloon, and we will prepare the lesion further.
Erupting nodule easy to break, but the outcome is very poor. Non-eruptic is very difficult to break it, and of course outcome is better. Do you agree, madam?
I'm sorry. Yeah, eruptive calcified nodule is even we have the good expansion, they can be reprotruded later on. So that's bad. But for now, that's a different story. We have to take care of the other calcium together. So I totally agree doing the additional treatment to make more fracture, and then making as much as big stent area. That's what we should do now.
So in the afternoon, because of the macrophages, inflammation existence, that is why the outcome is easy to break, but the outcome is bad.
Yes, yeah. But not everybody coming back. So okay. Still, we need a good expansion. And because we have the large calcium burden behind the calcified nodule, so that has to be break.
Correct.
Can we use IVL to break that calcium now? Or should we use coring balloon or cutting balloon for the remaining calcium?
As you can see before this rotablation, we were unable to take even a 1.25 balloon. Now we have managed to take a scoring balloon, which is rather bulky, a 3x10, and it went very easily. So I think we can do it a bit more. Yeah.
Fajila, so, Dr. Panja here. I want to question, why not use the bulbarine? I routine practice 90% cases bulbarine is very effective rather than the scoring balloon. Why you are choosing this scoring balloon in this case rather than the bulbarine?
Well, one fact is bulbarine is a great balloon, but I think it's a scoring balloon is more easier to maneuver than a bulbarine, and also I'm doing it for quite a long lesion, and for me scoring balloon works very well. That's why, I mean, it's personal preferences, isn't it? So I usually get away with using a scoring balloon, and it's easier to handle. That's, and it's also a lot less expensive. That's also another thing that, but a Wolverine is a great choice, and I mean, I also use Wolverine, but today we decided that we already use the Rota, so we go for a less expensive balloon, which is a scoring balloon, and we, as you can see, the balloon is opening up very nicely, and we hope that it's doing a pretty good job of diluting the vessel.
I think whether should we use the IVL or scoring or wobbling for this case, in terms of the imaging standpoint, I think scoring balloon seems to be perfect because calcium is multiple, but none of them was circumferential anymore. So that's, I think, very appropriate. And actually, it was confirmed. It's opening well.
Thank you. That's a great insight that you sort of told us. Yes, I think that and the imaging in this kind of complex cases, I think, is really changed the way we do procedures, and it did help us guide what tools to use, as you like. Because if there was if required, we would have had to use an IVL, and obviously the cost would have gone substantially. So the vessel looks like this right now. So the bed looks fine. Now the question is about the diagonal. So I was rewired that vessel and tried to open that up because it's quite a large size diagonal, isn't it? But the challenge is that the ostea of the diagonal is quite severely diseased.
Yes, definitely we need to wire the diagonal at present because Rota is done.
Right. So we do that. Let's see how the wire behaves.
I think even below, before the scoring balloon, probably we can put the wire. Sometimes dissection flap, something is there. Maybe it is difficult to wire the diagonal. Sometimes it can happen.
Yes, that's a very worthy observation. Yes, because sometimes if we do too much of dissection, it might be a challenge to wire the vessel. Can we? Can you have a spider view? Can you go to a spider view? So we go to a spider view. So please. Check please. I think I need a micro. I think I need the support of a micro, please. Because as you can see, the wire is buckling up. If I have the support of a micro, it would be easier for me to sure, because the ostia is very significantly diseased and it is not allowing the wire to enter. So what I'll do is, I'm going to take a micro. I think a micro would have been a much easier thing to take here. It would have allowed me to check, please. I'm not getting any support, so the check, please. There's a lesion here also. In the diagonal, in that segment, there's a tight lesion which is just sort of pushing my wire into a smaller branch and not allowing it to go forward. So if I had the micro, it would have given me the necessary leeway here also to go forward. Maybe I take the micro now. Can I have the micro, please? Oh, you can dilate the ostium and that might allow me to, can I take a 1.25 balloon then? Just a 1.25, please. So we'll just gently dilate the ostia of the diagonal. This will allow me, I think, more room to maneuver my wire, because the diagonal is severely diseased in the ostia as well as in that segment where the wire is being deviated towards the smaller branch of the diagonal. So I'm taking a 1.255. Okay. So let's see. So actually this is not a 1.25, this is a 2 by 10. Let's see how it behaves. It didn't go in. I think a 1.25 would have been a better idea maybe. Oh yes, now it's in.
Yeah. Which balloon is 1.25?
No, no, it's 2 by 10.
Okay.
So, with the support of the balloon,
yes,
I was able to negotiate my wire into the diagonal.
Big, large branch of D1.
There is quite a significant angle between the diagonal and the LED as well, and the balloon has sort of stuck.
Do you want osteoproximal? Here. There is some calcium also.
Yes, yes.
That is depressing the problem.
There's quite a bit of calcium, and that's what's preventing the balloon to go. Can I take a 1.25, please? The 1.25, please. I'll take the 1.25 instead of the 2. The calcium is quite substantial in the diagonal, and but I don't think that the diagonal is of the caliber that we should chase it with a rota. It would be counterproductive. So we are trying to take a 1.25 balloon now, and let's see how this behaves. The 2 did go, and we did manage to pass a wire effectively. So the 1.25 is going quite easily, but it still again got stuck in the calcium here. So we will dilate here. So 10 million in atmospheric pressure. With the scoring we went up to 16, 18. Here we've gone up to, but we are unable to cross our balloon here.
Yeah.
The ostia has been nicely opened with the tool, but this part is proving to be a challenge.
Whole entire artery is a medium-sized calcium is there.
I think this vessel is so heavily calcified, we managed to open the ostia of the diagonal. I don't think it's going to be worth chasing the mid-diagonal with too much aggressive dilatation. This is a 75-year-old gentleman. He's got a very long history of chronic stable angina. He's got CKD, diabetes. So we want to be gentle with him, and that was one of the reasons that we did a staged PCR during the RCA 5 days ago. So here we've managed to open up the LAD nicely. The diagonal, we've managed to open the ostia. So let us take a short angiographic shot now and see how things go, and then we can take the opinion of the panel about how to proceed further.
Yes.
So the diagonal ostia, we did do pre-dilatation with a 2 millimeter, 2 by 10 millimeter balloon. That mid diagonal lesion, we are unable to cross with a balloon. It's a balloon uncrossable lesion. But I think we are quite happy with the fact that we've managed to open up the ostia of the diagonal. Now, we've done quite a reasonable job of preparing the LAD lesion. So my idea would be to do stenting of the from the left main to LAD right now. We don't want to be too aggressive here.
Would you please try the proximal D1, same angioscalp, as at least two sides. You will try for the angioscalp. To opening for the osteoproximal
D1. For the ostia of the diagonal,
yeah.
We can do that. For the ostia of the diagonal, we can do that. We can do a scoring. That's a good idea, I think. Thank you for the suggestion. So, for the LAD, we have taken a 3 by 10 scoring. Here, we're taking a 2 by 10 entry scoring to open up the ostia of the diagonal.
Yeah.
Let's see. Doesn't go.
Very difficult to negotiate on the
ostia. Even our 2 by 10 scoring is not passing into the diagonal. Because there's severe calcium there, and also there's quite an angle which is not aligned. Even a scoring balloon is quite bulky compared to a normal balloon. And so, and it's not that flexible, so it's not budging there.
Prior to that, you should try to open by NC balloon is 2.5.
I take again the 2, the 2 by, I can take the 2 by 10 NC balloon, or I can go for a 2.5 by, so I'm taking a 2 by 10 NC balloon.
Any suggestion from the floor? Or
I have a crazy idea. So yeah. I check the OCT one more time and how looks like the OCTM of the diag in relation to the LAD region. So if that is not too close, we can put the two separate stents, not jailing the diag. Maybe nobody like that's
I think
we have opened by two the diagonal,
yeah.
And we are thinking about the one stent strategy, not two. So I think with two, it is less likely to get blocked with the. Stent to LAD. So in one stent strategy, if it is an open diagonal and we are going just Dmitri flow and with a one stent in the LAD.
Ultimately, if not open, that case they want a single stent strategy to be maintained.
Yeah.
So if the calcium proximus is very difficult to open, whether you can try for the rotor 1.25 may be effective also.
Yeah.
Of course, it's difficult to.
So the thing is, at the end of the day, what we want is to relieve our patient of his angina and also to have a safe procedure. So my take on this case is that I would like to just stent from left main to LAD, and if the diagonal, we don't use the diagonal, I'm quite happy with that result. Obviously, this is a very severely diseased and heavily calcified diagonal. And I'm not too keen to take a 1.25 bar into this vessel. I mean, it can be done, but the challenges are that it's not that large sized a vessel. And is it worth chasing? And is it worth taking the risk of getting this amount of myocardial territory? But the consequent risks are quite substantial. So as I've opened up the LAD, that RC has already been taken care of. And actually, after the RC opening, the patient also has said that he has had this quite substantial improvement in his symptoms over the last few days. But let's see, with the LAD opened up, I think he should be fine. So I think I would rather keep the diagonal like this and hope that it doesn't get closed. We've opened the OSCE and I'm quite hopeful that we won't lose this diagonal. So I'm taking a stent right now.
Yeah.
So we're
taking a 3x38 synergy.
Yeah. One more point, and if we want to use
GTN and
if we want to use 1.25 bar into the diagonal, we need to remove the LAD wire again.
Yes, we
that
need
will
to
be
do
the
that. And do we want to do
so
that?
We have to switch.
So I'm taking our synergy stent, a 3x38 synergy stent. From left main to LAD. And I removed the wire from the diagonal because it's such a calcified vessel and I'm not too keen to keep a wire there, and then once I've deployed the stent to pull and push the wire.
You are correct decision, otherwise you try further more, so it causes the deleterious effect on the side branch. It are ultimately closed, so better to abandon it, and you have right decision taken, put the stent on the LAD.
So the synergy goes beautifully in this calcified vessel which was treated with rotor ablation. I'm removing the wire from the diagonal.
So I think we have to watch the time because Hungary is waiting. And this is obviously this is more work to do and this is complex.
So yes, I will finish off and you can see the end result.
We can join.
Yes.
Right.
It's been a very, very, very informative session. You have teaching us a lot. Obviously, this is a very challenging and complex case. We thank you for doing this on a Sunday for us. But Europe is waiting for the valve implant. So thank you very, very much.
I totally understand. Thank you.
Thank you so much, and good luck on your next steps, okay?
Right. So if you can come back and have a look for the final results, that would be wonderful.
Okay, we'll try to do that.
Okay, thank you, Fazila, and
your, thank you.
Thank for your team.
Thank you.
Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, madam, and Dr. Srinivas Kumari here. We are back with you. Wanted to show the final shots.
So we took a 3x38 synergy, and after deploying it, you'll be happy to see that the diagonal is flowing fine. And then we did post dilatation of the proximal part with a 4x8 millimeter balloon. MC balloon went up to very high pressure, and for the rest, we did it with a 3x5 millimeter balloon. And after post-dilatation, let's have a final, so this is the final angiographic view, but the show that there was some malapposition and under-expansion, so we did further post-dilatation again, and after that, it looked a lot better. So we went and did post-dilatation again, and this is the final result. And the OCT is also showing that it's just fine. Can we have another AP? Yeah, so this is the final result.
Yeah.
Angiographically and OCT looks also fine.
Yeah,
so after we did post dilatation.
Thank you very much.
So that's us done.
You should not worry for the diagonal, because at least 2 to 3 diagonal is there.
Yes, it is there. Thank you. So thank you for giving us the opportunity of sharing this case with you. We are truly grateful. Thank you so much.
Thank you, madam. Thank you.